This is Dalia. I've been a tour guide since 2008, and being a tour guide is the best thing happened in my entire life because it's not just a job, it's a passion. And being a tour guide, it's a good way to meet a new people and see the world through them, and the best rewarding way to be in someone's happiest holiday memory. I'm standing in one of the famous streets in Cairo, and the old street in Cairo is called el-Muizz Street, and it's considered the heart of Islamic Cairo. And this Cairo was founded by one of the rulers called the Caliph el-Muizz, which this street named after him in around 969 AD. And when it was built, it was surrounded by many gates from all sides, and it was open in the morning and closed at night, and no one is allowed to enter the city until it's open in the next day. We know that Cairo is called the city of 1,000 minarets. Why is that? Because the big numbers of the mosques we have here in Cairo, and you know this street containing around 72 Islamic monuments. So imagine how many minarets we have here. And what is the minaret? This is what we call it, this tower we call it a minaret. And the minaret was one of the major elements of any mosque, and it was used by the leader of the prayer, or we call it in Arabic imam, to go up and for calling for prayer to remind everyone for the prayer times. And also it's helped the stranger of the city when they coming and looking for a mosque, they will know it from the minaret. Now we are standing in one of the largest markets in the Middle East, and it's considered the largest and the oldest one here in Cairo. We call it Khan el-Khalili. Khan is the Arabic word for the market, and Khalili is the name of the person who founded this place for the first time in the 14th century. So when you come to Egypt, it's not just about to learn history, it's about to come and to know more about the locals and to see the real Cairo. So the real experience here, when you come here and get lost in the narrow streets of the market, and here it's a good way to haggle and bargain and to chat with the local, and it's to also to if you want to practice your Arabic here in Egypt. So it's containing about 50 coffee shops, but guess what? I'm gonna take you in one of the famous coffee shop here in the market, and it's considered the oldest coffee shop here. It's called el-Fishawi coffee shop, and it's a very, very famous, and it's old because many celebrities used to come and sit in this coffee shop, like King Farouk, who is the last king of Egypt, and also Naguib Mahfouz, our famous Egyptian writer, the one who won Nobel Prize for his famous novel, The Trilogy of Cairo, and many, 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 many celebrities used to come here and sit for the experience, just sitting and watching what the people, watching the people, and to know what's going around. Imagine now we are sitting in one of the famous and oldest coffee shop here in the market. This is where King Farouk, our last king of Egypt, used to come and sit here. And also Naguib Mahfouz, our famous writer, the one who won Nobel Prize, also used to come and sit here. They have many varieties of drinks, but I choose for you the two famous ones. If you are a tea lover and if you like hot drink, the best choice is our traditional mint tea, and as you see, this is our fresh tea, fresh mint. And if it's too hot for you and you want a refreshing drink, this is your best choice. And of course, many of you read about our drink, which we call it kakarde, or it's the hibiscus. And this is the best drink, the best one to drink it in our hot weather. So I hope everyone can travel again, and the world will open for us soon. And hope to see you soon again in my lovely country, Egypt, with inspiring vacation.